Friends, this is Mukilan.
This is Bien.
And welcome back to Yellowstone National Park. We are driving along the Firehole River. As you might remember, this river contains the water from hot geysers and hot springs.
I want to go swimming in the river.
Well, you could, but the swimming area is temporarily closed for the season. Alright, we have a jam-packed video today. We're going to see Firehole Falls, Steamboat Geyser, Yellowstone Lake, the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone, along with two very beautiful falls, and the most iconic hot spring in Yellowstone, the Grand Prismatic. Let's jump right into it. Here's the beautiful Firehole Falls. We're going to take a short hike down to get a closer look at the water. We've already hiked down. Look at all the rapids!
This is hard. It's so fun. That water is so green.
Next stop is Norris Geyser Basin, home of the Steamboat Geyser. It's a short hike on the boardwalk to get to the Steamboat Geyser. On the way, let's check out this emerald pool. Welcome to the world's tallest active geyser, Steamboat. This geyser can send water up to 300 feet into the air, which is 2 to 3 times the height of Old Faithful. But it can go without eruption from 4 days to 50 years. That's how it got its nickname, the Old Unpredictable. Aww, we just missed a major eruption. The last major eruption happened the day before we visited. But we still have the minor eruptions, and it's a great sight to watch.
There's so much steam.
We are driving through Hayden Valley.
Bison again.
Here's a riddle for you. What did the bison say to his calf when he was leaving for work? Bison! Hee hee hee. We're in the mud volcano area, and this is the Mud Cauldron. If you look closely, you can see the waves in the water. we are at the scenic Yellowstone Lake. This is the largest high elevation lake in North America. It sits at 7,700 feet above sea level, and it's so beautiful.
Let's play on the beach.
The water is so cold. In fact, the lake stays cold year round. In winter, the lake freezes up entirely into ice. All right, I'm going to get to the big rock so I can soak in the relaxing view.
I want to climb the rocks. This is so much fun.
This is so serene. Here we are at the Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. The Yellowstone River runs through this canyon, which is 800 feet to 1,200 feet deep. On its way, the river forms two very beautiful waterfalls. This one is called the Upper Falls. Here is the Lower Falls. Right here, the Yellowstone River plunges 300 feet in depth.
The waterfall is so tall.
Chipmunk. He's running around like he's not on top of a cliff or something. But then, chipmunks are pretty acrobatic, am I right?
Right, Bo. Hey, chipmunk. Stay safe.
Here's a panoramic view of the magnificent canyon. Now I know why it's called Yellowstone. Look at the color of the canyon!
Hee hee hee!
Stop Midway Geyser Basin. This geyser basin is home to Excelsior Geyser and the Grand Prismatic. This is the Excelsior Geyser Crater. This used to be the world's largest active geyser. During the 1880s, this geyser had a series of violent eruptions. These eruptions seem to have damaged the geyser's inner structure. Now the geyser is dormant and it's more of a hot spring. The steam over there is so colorful. I bet that's the Grand Prismatic. These terraces look so interesting. These are formed by hot water from the spring depositing minerals on the ground.
I see orange, red, blue, all kinds of colors.
We can barely see the center of the spring, and yet there's so many colors here. I think we gotta get an aerial view to see the whole spring. Good thing that there's an observation point on top of the hill. Let's go hike! All right, we are going to the Grand Prismatic Overlook. It's about a 1.2-mile hike. So, we'll get there easily. It's a really hot day. I'm glad I have my hat and trees for shade. Here we are! Whoa! This view is so grand! This is what I call the beauty of nature. Do you know what creates these beautiful colors? The temperature of the water in the hot spring varies from the center of the hot spring, which is very, very hot, to the outer rings of the hot spring, which are somewhat cooler, but still, it's 131 degrees per Fahrenheit. Different species of heat-loving bacteria live in these varying temperatures. And when clustered together, they appear as brilliant bands of color. With that, we say bye to Yellowstone. Be sure to like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Bye!
Bye!